first year in office, or the anniversary of your first year in office.
We were together a year ago.
A year ago, yeah. But is it This American Carnage, right?
Right.
That day. And the largest crowds ever. Large crowds today, marching. He can't go to the party. The government is shut down.
Right. Look, it has been a chaotic first year by anyone's standards. I think Stephen Moore would even agree with me on that. It has been.
He was taking a second team, by the way.
Sorry about that, but he would agree. I mean, it has been chaotic by any standard. And so why not the first year this way, with a government shutdown, with the president all set to celebrate, and now stuck inside the White House with nowhere to go, and no deal in sight. In a way, the president has things that he wants to brag about, and he's done that in tweets today. But the celebration that he wanted to have is marred by the fact that Congress can't get its act together, and that he is embroiled yet again in a partisan fight that could have been avoided, and that a couple of weeks ago, after that congressional meeting where it was all sweetness and light, and the president said, I would take the heat and we'll get this done, bring me something and I'll sign it, we thought foolishly something might have gotten done.
Well, yeah,
it didn't.
The White House is calling this, Mark, a hostage negotiation. Who blinks first, then, in this negotiation?
Unfortunately, they're both going to have to blink. And when I say they're both, it's going to have to be President Trump and Chuck Schumer. That seems to be the only ones right now that are really talking and are having a dialogue, even though the dialogue seems to get clouded.
McConnell has no power?
No. I mean, look, no disrespect to Mitch McConnell at this point, but in some ways, this is out of his hands because President Trump has... and his administration specifically have taken such a leadership role. I don't want to say that they are leading, but they have taken a leadership role on the Republican side. So if you're a Republican senator, if you're a Republican House member, in many ways you have to wait to see what President Trump does in his discussions with Chuck Schumer before any of this gets resolved.
Yeah. So Stephen, let's bring you in since Gloria invoked.
Now you have to bring me.
This has been many months in the making because the Trump administration announced the end of the DACA program. This was back in September. The federal funding for the Children's Health Insurance Program called CHIP ran out on September 30th. They have to pass three. They have passed three short-term spending bills since then. They had months to figure this out.
Yeah.
So why can't they just get the job done?
Well, because there's a very serious disagreement about one of the most important policy issues in America, which is our immigration system. I mean, I want to step back a minute to go back to what Jim Acosta said when he said America is broken. I strongly disagree with that. I mean, America has hardly ever been healthier, not in the last 20 years have we seen such a ferociously strong economy.
Would you say the government is broken at this point?
Exactly. And our political system. Yeah. But our country, I mean, my goodness, I mean, every indicator on the economy is pointing straight north. Donald Trump did not want this to happen, as Gloria was saying. You know, this was supposed to be a big day of celebration for the president, and instead they have to deal with this. I do not believe, despite that picture with them smiling, look, the White House is concerned about this. They want to get this done. And let me just finally say, I've been in Washington a long time, for 35 years. This is one of the dumbest crises I've ever seen. There's no reason they can't pass a temporary bill for whether it's a week or 2 weeks or 3 weeks or 4 weeks to keep the government open and keep the negotiations going. That's what the Republicans wanted to do. And I think Democrats may have taken a bridge too far here. One other quick point. If you look at the vote last night in the Senate, it's really interesting to look at the three senators who voted no on with the president. Manchin of West Virginia, Donnelly of Indiana, and the other one is Heidi Hattie from North Dakota. Those are all three Democrats in really tough, tight races. They didn't want this to happen either.
You have Republicans on the other side who are tough races.
I think, what was the final vote? I think there were only a couple of
I think the Republicans are like Mike Lee and Lindsey Graham. They're out of
game. 50-40. The Republicans are pretty unified here.
Okay, so here's my question. And as I was talking to David Rode last night, as we were sitting here watching all this, he says, I think this is going to go on for a while.
Yeah.
The sentiment I get from people is that this is going to go on for a while.
You mean the shutdown is going to go
yes.
on? Yes. I don't believe
so.
Yes, it will.
My question, it sounds silly, but you know what I mean. The longer this goes on, the longer it goes on. Kirsten, is that?
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's right. But I also think, I just wanted to throw out something you just said, this is over immigration. It's not really over immigration. It's about over really one issue. It's over a DACA fix, right. Something that helps some young people that were brought into this country through no fault of their own stay here that most people agree on. So we're not actually trying to the Democrats and the Republicans aren't trying to reform the entire immigration system through this. So that's where this becomes sort of questionable of why is this happening? Because this isn't something that could be fairly easily fixed, right? And I think that when you have Chuck Schumer going to the president and saying, we'll give you money for the border wall, which is just toxic to the Democratic base. I mean, really, you cannot overstate how toxic it is to the Democratic base. That shows some good faith on the Democratic side of basically saying, we'll do something we really, really don't want to do so we can keep the dreamers in the country. And the Republicans are like, no.
Yeah.
So I don't know. To me, I don't know how to be. I understand the idea of trying to pin on the Democrats, but it just doesn't seem like.
The Democrats started a filibuster that literally shut down the government, though. I mean, that's why you pin it on them. They could have easily kept the government up.
But they could have voted on DACA a number of times. It came up in 2010.
That's a separate issue.
Here's the thing. The Republicans are in charge, and they know they don't have enough votes. And so what does that mean? That means that they go and they negotiate with the people whose votes they need. That's the way it normally works.
Yeah.
Instead, they basically said, you have to sign on to something that you don't support. It's not even true that they support what's in the bill. So Republicans are saying, you won't support this. It's not true. They want a longer extension than that. So if you want those votes and you can't even keep all your Republicans together, then you're going to have to give
Democrats. But Democrats voted against a continuing resolution that would have kept the government open, and they voted against the six-year funding of the Silver Tax.
So here's a question, April. As I said, this has come up before.
Yeah.
Right, DACA has come up before. They had plenty of time to deal with it. I think the question comes down to one of trust. If there was someone there that they could trust, they may say, well, we can trust this person. He's going to give us DACA after if we sign up to this. I think they may not trust that they're going to get to it after this.
You're square on the head. There is a crisis of confidence, within the Republican Party for their own president because he's been waffling back and forth on this issue. There's a crisis of confidence with the Democrats with this president. There is a situation where people feel that they're not working in good faith with the president who has said he's going to show so many wins. And I think his track record has shown that he doesn't work well when his back is up against the wall with his own party as well as the Democrats.
Do you know how long we've been debating this immigration issue?
It's not about how long.
15 years.
But
the idea that we're going to solve this
in 3 or 4 weeks. You're a president. Right. And our president. He went and said, I'm going to have wins. You're going to have the biggest wins. I'm a great negotiator.
Right.
The spotlight and the microscope is on him right now. He is not negotiating with the Democrats. At a time like this, he's lacked empathy in the past. There are people who are furloughed right now, and you don't know how long this is going to last. And the problem is, this is a man who he has no problems backing up and saying, I'm going to let you hurt before it happens. He's going to watch to make the other person blink. And while the other person is waiting to watch the other person blink, there are people who are...
Okay, I got to get to the break. But before we get to the break, and I promise you, we got...